That's the significance of Shabbat. Things get a little cloudy in our life. We're a little out of focus. Our attention is drawn here and there and everywhere. We concern ourselves with what happens in other states. We concern ourselves with what happens in other countries. We concern ourselves with everybody's cares, everything's going on in our families. Everything's happening in the workplace. Even the darn weather. Our focus is everywhere but where it really belongs. And that's what Shabbat does. It brings everything in our lives into focus. It brings us back to a proper perspective of what we are, what we are about, and what we are to do and be. That it's about Yeshua.
She's working with the drivers in the
Just like Billy Graham said, if you hear anything I say today, hear this. God loves you. And that was his message. And how do we know? Because he so loved the world, he gave his only son. He loved the world.
She went in on Amazon's website.
He didn't say he loved the church.
But I'll ask her.
He said he loved the world. That he gave his son.
Yeah, she set up a home office. And she has
confessing his name. Believe in your heart. That's the message for this holiday season. Come to get him, it's still working.
5 days a week, 8 hours a day.
He loves you when you fall short. He loves you with your evil inclination. He loves you with your selfishness. He loves you when you're at your worst. And he loves you when you're at your best.
Yeah, she just turned
nine, so God loves you. Now you can say it to yourself. Say, God loves me. Yes, he does. Now take your time to love your neighbors a little bit too, because we ought to love our neighbors as ourselves. Amen?
Yeah, let's see what I can do.
Thank you.
Sure that we
keep sending out prayers for our Mary Lou and our Eugene, who desperately need it all the time. We make sure we put them on our prayer list every week. We've got Mike Foster is desperately in need of a job and a home to call his own. So we're going to lift him up in prayer. Yep, absolutely. We would like to make sure that we bless. There's a lot of supporters of this ministry that are here. So let's send out a little prayer for them as well. Send out a prayer for all of our little ones. Exactly. Who get a lot of love and a lot of smooches while they're here. They need a covering because, as you well know by the news that we've got, this is it's a pretty horrible world when they target the kids. And that's what they're doing, is targeting the kids. Stephanie would like to say something.
Oh, can you just pray for my cousin Cheryl was just diagnosed with 4-stage pancreatic cancer.
Oh.
She's 49.
Cheryl, what's your last name?
Cheryl Lovell.
All right, we're going to send out a healing prayer for Cheryl Lovell. Mm-hmm. Mike?
Yeah, say a prayer for my son and his fiance. They were in Massachusetts, and after 7 years, they've moved back. And, they're very capable, and it's just finding a decent job.
Absolutely.
And a place to live.
So get them settled home.
Right.
Absolutely. Yeah.
And Mary Mike Lou? Needs a computer so he can go to work for Amazon.
Okay. That would be wonderful. All right, any other prayer requests that we've got today? I'm here. Bring it on. I'm scared. All right. Yes?
For my two sons, for their salvation. They hate my guts, but that's okay. I still love them.
Absolutely.
No, they do. It's because of my youngest brother's. Crippled my youngest brother, too. He carries that spirit of anti-religion, anti-God, and everything.
What are their names?
Their names, well, my brother's name's Keith.
Keith?
And then my two sons is Mark and Vincent.
Mark and Vincent.
Yeah.
So we'll lift them up.
Who's that guy that needs a job?
A big friend?
Who's that guy that needs a job?
Mike Foster's right there.
Oh, hey, Mike.
I'm sure you guys can talk at O.N.A.
Oh, okay.
Put your heads together and see what you can do. That would be wonderful. We are blessed with the worship team that we've got. So I'm very excited about that. We would like a guitarist so that this guy here doesn't have to do so many acrobatics on the stage. That would be wonderful. Also, everybody is welcome to O.N.A. We're a little different in that we eat after every service because we like the fellowship. We like to feed our bodies after we feed our spirit. So, absolutely, please plan on staying because you know what I'm talking about. it's just an amazing thing when you've got this kind of a community and this kind of a family that you can sit down and we share some of the most interesting Torah studies over O.N.A. So you just plan on coming and staying. We'll treat you really well and feed you really well. So, all right, that's it for me.